Welcome to the third day of our episode where we are looking at the journey of the martyrdom in Uganda. And today we are looking at those who were killed and who killed them. As we very well know, we have the Catholics and we have the Anglicans. In fact, the Anglicans were more than the Catholics. And were killed in different ways. And these people were brought from different areas. Some walked from Munyonyo, others from the palace. So they were brought from there on foot. Others, because of the journey, they got tired, and they could force them to walk, but on losing energy, they could fall down and be dragged. So in that process, you have been dragged for a long distance. Some of them reached here with very few energy left. But on reaching here, some were stabbed, others were pierced, others were beheaded, others were castrated. A lot was done. Others were chopped into pieces. And then finally, it was burning. They were burnt to ash. So that is how they were killed. But as we've said, we have the Anglicans, and they were more than the Catholics. And we also have the Catholics. All of them were killed at Namugongo, still in the same way. They were brave, much as all that happened. They remained strong. They believed in God. They never gave up on their faith. And we thank God for such kind of brave men who stood for their faith. We have men like Buza Bariyawo. Most of them were pigs. All of them, by the way, pigs. They were working servants, younger men serving in the palace. Yeah. We have Buza Bariyawo, we have Joe Jagenda, we have Mnyaga Byanjo, and many others. I can't recall all the names. The one who was in charge of killing was Mukajanga, the chief executioner. We thank God for today's journey of martyrdom, and that is what we can talk about, the way they were killed. Tomorrow we shall begin from there. God bless you.